So you're thinking about trying Suitsupply's custom-made program. Well, I just tried it. I'm going to show you how the suit, the shirt, and the coat that I got fits on me, and I'll share my honest opinion on whether or not this program is worth your money. Suitsupply as a brand needs no introductions. They're often touted as the best place to buy a suit right now. You know, boomers had Men's Wearhouse and millennials have Suitsupply. I've even recommended this Dutch clothier to pretty much anybody who asks me, you know, where they should get a wedding suit or a groomsman suit. I usually bring them to Suitsupply. Sure, Suitsupply has caught some heat over the years for their aggressive marketing campaigns, like the one they recently launched. That's all over the inside of their stores, by the way, so you might see some of it in the B-roll of this video. And some people have had bad experiences with their in-store reps. They say they have a little bit of an attitude or a little bit of pretension. But personally, I've never had a problem with them. I've always had a pretty good experience in Suitsupply shops. And really, at the end of the day, the only thing that matters is, do they make a good suit and is it a good value? And the answer is yes. Now, Suitsupply is relatively affordable. It's not cheap. There are cheaper suits out there, even cheaper custom suits. But for what you're getting, it's a good price. Having said all that, personally, I've never really had luck with Suitsupply suits. I tried one of their ready-to-wear suits a few years ago. It was a Lazio. It was a 32 regular with alterations. And it didn't really fit that well on me even after alterations. It was passable, it was fine, but I never really felt great in it. It was clearly made for somebody taller and with a different build, and I ended up donating that suit. And you know, that was a $600 suit after alterations, so definitely not cheap. So after that experience, I had sort of written Suitsupply off, but that all changed recently. Suitsupply's marketing department recently reached out to me and asked if I'd like to test drive their newly revamped custom-made program. Now, I know Suitsupply does sponsorships with some YouTube channels. This video isn't sponsored. They did give me this suit for free in exchange for my honest review, but they have no control over the content. They don't get to review it. They don't even know when it's going to be published. Now, since these reviews take a lot of work, I figured, why not just swing for the fences? I asked them if I could try the full getup, so a custom suit, custom shirt, and custom overcoat. Yes, they have custom overcoats now, and they agreed. They said I could try the suit, shirt, and jacket with no restrictions, so any fabrics, any details, and extra add-ons. Now, their custom suits start at $498, and the price goes up depending on which fabrics you choose and also which details and extras that you choose. Their custom shirts start at $119, and their custom coats start at $499. Typically, it takes 2 to 3 weeks for Suitsupply to cut, sew, and deliver your suit, but during periods of high demand, it can take 6 to 7 weeks. My entire suit order took about 4 weeks to be completed. And the process basically has you starting online and then finishing up in the store to get your measurements. So let's start with the online portion. So Suitsupply has a design your own tool on their website. If you've ever built a custom garment on, like, you know, any made-to-measure brand like Indochino, you're probably familiar with this kind of interface. You pick your garment type and then you pick your fabric. Suitsupply has over 1,000 fabrics to choose from. You choose your construction method and your details, and you see all of your changes reflected on the website in real time as you make them. This type of online suit designer at one point was like mind-blowing, but now it's pretty commonplace. I will say that Suitsupply does a good job with theirs. Feels kind of like what I imagine driving a Volkswagen feels like. It's just clean and polished, everything's intuitive and where you expect it to be. Now, they do offer as many or even more customization options than other made-to-measure brands like your Indochinos of the world, and they include a few options that I've never seen anywhere else. Like, they have more types of shoulder construction than I've ever seen with another brand. You know, between the different types of canvassing and the shoulder construction and the lining options, you can create a pretty unique suit jacket or sport coat with Suitsupply. For your suit pants or your odd trousers, you can choose your preferred type of waistband, closure, and fly. You can add pleats, cuffs, pick stitching. You can add suspender buttons and unique pocket types. I really like that you can add side adjusters to the waistband. When I'm going custom, I always do side adjusters over belts. I think they're just a superior way to keep your pants up, and they create a little bit of a cleaner, more formal look. Even the optional waistcoat can be customized to some extent. That's a nice touch. For their custom outerwear, which right now is just basically overcoats, you can choose between 6 different fabrics, wool, cashmere, camel, and some blends, and 3 different styles. And then from there, you can customize like the length, the lining, and the buttons. The bottom line is, I think that Suitsupply did a great job with their online customization tool, but none of that really matters if they can't deliver a garment that actually fits properly. So let's move on. Since Suitsupply offered a full getup with no restrictions, you better believe that I took full advantage of this. So here's what I chose. First up, the suit. It's a blend of brown wool, silk, and linen, so it's got a lot of texture and depth to it. The total price for that was $1,087. The jacket is a two-button, double vent. It's a fully canvas jacket, but it's their light canvassing, so it is structured, but it's not quite as heavy as a traditional full canvas jacket. It has narrow notched lapels, a natural shoulder, and flap pockets. The pants have a double hook closure, so this is a hook instead of a button, just kind of a cleaner look. Side adjusters, a zip fly, single pleats on the front, cuffs, and these are short cuffs, about 4 centimeters, and they're half lined. For the waistcoat, I went with 4 buttons, a notch lapel, which I think looks good if you plan on wearing it alone without a jacket, straight pockets, and a fabric back. And again, for waistcoats, if you're gonna wear them alone, I really think the fabric back looks a lot better than like a polyester or a lined back. For the custom shirt, I went with a cotton twill. It's kind of like a light blue hairline stripe, mother of pearl buttons because why not, and a wide spread collar. Finally, for the overcoat, I went with a navy wool. I've never had a navy overcoat, and I think it's a really versatile color. I'm gonna get a lot of wear out of it. I went with the thigh length. I like my top coats to hit right at mid-thigh. Brown and light brown buttons, and paisley blue lining, just for a little bit of subtle flair. So I started with these designs online, and then you save them and you can send them to your stylist. So in this case, I sent them over to Jared at Suitsupply's Georgetown location. Now, based on Jared's recommendation, we did end up making some tweak to the design in the store, but most of our time spent together was just getting my measurements right. So let's talk about getting measured in person, because this is really the part of the process that will make or break your custom suit or shirt or jacket. And some brands get it right, some brands don't. It really comes down to who you're working with and how good they are. It doesn't matter how many customization options you choose. It doesn't matter how expensive your fabric is. If your suit doesn't fit right, it's not gonna look good. And that's the problem with a lot of the brands that do self-measurement, where you give them your own measurements that you take at home, either by yourself or with a friend. It's very easy to screw up your own measurements. So if you can get measured by an expert at the store, that's always the way to go. So I really like Suitsupply's start online and finish in the store approach. It makes a lot of sense, but you do have to be able to get to a Suitsupply location. And I do want to say that Jared, who is Suitsupply's custom made specialist at their Georgetown location in Washington, D.C., was an absolute pleasure to work with. He was friendly, knowledgeable, and laid back. I never felt rushed, even when the store was kind of busy. Of course, he was very well dressed. And an added bonus was Jared has a similar build to me, so he's kind of a svelte guy, and so he understood some of the specific fit issues that I usually deal with. So he had me try on a fitting garment for each piece, the jacket, pants, shirt, and coat, and then he built out a measurement profile based on adjustments to those try-on garments. So this is a pretty standard approach used by most made-to-measure brands that I've worked with. It's not bespoke, it's custom or made to measure, and you know, done right, it can work out really well, but some brands do it better than others. For example, some brands only adjust the length of your jacket, but they don't actually change the pocket placement or the button stance, and that can throw off the overall proportions of your suit. Jared explained that Suitsupply does adjust the button stance and the pocket placement based on how much they lengthen or shorten your jacket. So for me, that means that the pockets and the button stance came up just a little bit. And that sort of attention to detail is really important, especially if you don't have an average build. So we finished up my measurements, and about 3.5 weeks later, the clothes arrived back at the Georgetown location, ready for me to try on. I went back to the shop, tried everything on, and I'm happy to report that this custom Suitsupply suit fit much better than the off-the-rack Suitsupply suit that I tried on a few years ago. The waistcoat, the overcoat, and the shirt fit just right, no tailoring needed. The jacket sleeves were shortened just a tiny bit to show a little bit more shirt cuff, but all the important stuff like the shoulders and the length, those were good to go. The pants were taken in and hemmed just a little bit, and the cool thing is these minor alterations are handled in store, so they were actually done the same day. And the final product is really nice. I'm really happy with it. In fact, I think it's one of the best custom suits that I have in terms of fit and feel, And, you know, it doesn't have any of those issues that I always deal with, I feel like, with suits, like collar gap and sleeve pitch. It fits really well, and I feel good wearing it. So, do I recommend Suitsupply Custom Made? Yeah, I mean, I've tried a lot of different made-to-measure brands, a lot of custom suits, Oliver Wicks, Black Lapel, Indochino, you know, even bespoke companies like Allen David, other made-to-measure brands like Lanieri and Not Standard, and a few others. And Suitsupply, it's one of the best experiences that I've had. If I were to buy another suit from Suitsupply, I would definitely go custom, and I would not go off the rack with them just because I had such a good experience with their custom-made program. Now, if you're going to Suitsupply for the first time, definitely try on their off-the-rack stuff first, because they do have a pretty wide range of sizes and a variety of different cuts, so you probably could find something that fits well off the rack with alterations. But if you have a really tough to fit body type like I do, consider going custom. Really, the only downside is you have to be able to get to a Suitsupply location, and depending on where you live, that could be a little tricky. But if you can make that happen, I definitely recommend Suitsupply Custom Made for your next suit, shirt, or top coat. As always, I'd love to hear from you. So if you've tried Suitsupply Custom, go ahead and share your experiences down in the comment section and let me know what you think of the suit and the jacket that Suitsupply made for me. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. Thank you, as always, for watching. And until next time, stay stylish.